What's up, guys? We are here in Zion National Park today, and we're either going to get a nice sunset or a nice storm, one or the other. Stay tuned to find out. Guys, welcome back. So we're here at Observation Trail, or Observation Point Trail, in Zion National Park in southern Utah. Now, we're not at the top of the observation point. It's about 4 miles straight up, and I'm about a third of the way up right now. My buddy Brad went ahead and went up to the top, so I think he's gonna get some good stuff here, which I got a really good view of. I got a nice rock formation, and I got the Virgin River coming around, so I have a pretty decent composition here. Photographing this type of sunset is pretty it's a little challenging. Canyon walls, they make it kind of difficult. They play like the lighting is kind of weird. It throws you off a little bit because everything's so underexposed on the side of the canyon, and then you're shooting into the sun, so you got the sky up there that's way overexposed. Now, what I recommend on this type of thing is expose for the sky, expose for the highlights. So make sure your highlights are properly exposed, and then it'll underexpose your canyon walls a little bit, but you can always pull the shadows up in post, and I think that's probably the best way to go. Now, I got filters on there like I usually do. I have a three-stop grad filter on there to even out the sky. So if you don't have that, then I would suggest exposing for the highlights and then pulling up the shadows in post. You know, that's, I think, the best way to go about it. A couple things when you're photographing into the sun. The first thing I like to do is when you get the sun coming down, it starts to break the horizon. I like to shoot a sun star. Now, how you shoot a sun star is you take your aperture and you put it to F16 or above. F16, F18, F20, or F22. Any one of those will create a sun star. What happens is your aperture blades inside your lens, when it gets really small, creates a light refraction. And what that does is that creates those sun spikes. Now, I like to do that when the sun breaks the horizon. And after it goes down, it takes a little while because this isn't actually a true sunset because the canyon walls are so high. So what I'm going to do is, as the sun starts to go down, it's actually going to set probably a half an hour, 45 minutes after it crosses the top of these this ridge here. So once that happens, it's going to be a little bit. And then once the color comes out, if it doesn't storm too much, like I said, we'll see how it turns out here with this storm. But so there's two different things you can do when shooting into the sun. You know, wait till the sun, after the sun sets, you get the nice orange glow with the pink in the clouds, and you know, the really get the orange in the clouds too. It really looks really nice. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're talking about shooting into the sun. So stay tuned. I'm gonna show you guys my sun spike as soon as it crosses the canyon wall. And then after that, we're going to wait till the sun goes down, and I'm going to get that nice warm glow. So stay tuned. All right, guys, so we just got done filming the sun star. So what I do is, when that sun breaks the horizon there, I put it at F22 and I bracketed my exposures. Now what that means is I shot a normal exposure with my meter on my camera so it looked properly exposed. But when that happens, you know, the sky is really blown out. So what I do is I shoot one at the proper exposure, one at one stop underexposed, and a second one at two stops underexposed. And what happens is it brings down those highlights, but it underexposes the shadows a little bit, but I can mess with that in post-processing. And one other trick that I learned is when you photograph a sun star, what you get is those sun flares that come across the your screen there, or come across your image. And sometimes that can look kind of cool, but I don't like it, especially on this image. So what I do is, is I stick my fingers, you'll see in the first image, you'll see the sun stars. And you'll see the sun star, and you're gonna see the sun flares coming across the image. And I don't like the way that looks. Now, in post-processing, you can maybe clone it out, or you can, you know, use a spot healing brush and possibly clone it out. But the better idea, and what I like to do, the better solution is actually stick your fingers in front of the camera. So take your normal shots with your sun star, take the same exact settings, and stick your hand in front of the camera and your finger and cover the sun. That blocks out all the sun ray, the sun flares that come out. And in post-processing, you take it into Photoshop and you stack them, and you take a black brush and you just simply mask out the sunspots or the sun rays, the sun flares on it. So it's a really nice trick that I learned that I like to do. You'll see in the first picture, you'll see the sun star, and then you'll see the sun flares. In the second picture now, you're gonna see my hand in the way, and it's gonna block out, you're gonna see no more sun flares. Now, we're gonna wait for the sun to go down. It's gonna be a little bit, so I'm gonna eat my sandwich here, and I hope you guys enjoy another time lapse. I decided to switch up my composition a little bit. Now, when you're sitting here for a long amount, for, you know, a good amount of time, you know, you're taking a few shots, don't get tied down to one composition. You know, you get a good shot, like with the sun star, I don't want to have the same exact shot over and over again. So I'm happy with what I got. So now I'm going to try and go, I'm moved about 100 yards down to the right, and I'm going to try and include some of these really interesting rocks and these rock formations that are down here in my next shot. So, moving down here, and I'm gonna see how this thing goes. So what now we're gonna do is, I'm waiting until the sun actually sets, and I can wait for that, and those nice, you know, sunset colors, you know, the oranges and the pinks to come out. So this next composition I like a lot too. So let's see how this goes. I'm gonna put my filters on. I'm gonna take a couple different shots with some long exposures, some without the filters, and just kind of see how it goes. So. Really appreciate you guys watching this, and also my buddy Brad, his I'm gonna leave a link to his Instagram. You guys check it out. He got really good stuff. He lives here in southern Utah. So, and then I'm gonna end the video with some footage of earlier today. We did some exploring in some kind of a hidden trail, and we saw some bighorn sheep and some really cool rock formations. So I'll show you guys some of that. And that about does it for the video. Feel free to subscribe if you want to see more videos, more tutorials or anything. Just maybe leave a comment below and tell me what you'd like to see. And maybe hit the thumbs up button too if you guys don't mind. So thank you guys. I appreciate you guys watching this, and we'll see you guys on the next one.